for my show. Why I do a lot for my show is because I want people to know how hard we work in the baking industry. So when I'm out there, whether I'm filming or decorating or whatever, I'm always trying to let people know, you know, what we put into what we do and how much we love what we love to do. It's funny, I've been doing demos like this at conventions for a long time now. This probably go back maybe about 12, 15 years ago, and I would do them in the Atlantic City convention. Because I've always been about sharing. I've always been about helping the fellow baker out. I've always been about, you know, sharing stories about business and success. And that's really who I am. So when I'm on the show and I'm doing different things, I'm doing it not only for me, I'm doing it for the industry that's been so good to me and my family for all these years. I want people to know how hard you guys work. Okay, I want people to know what it's like to be a baker, what it's like to get the feeling if you decorate a cake and, you know, it just touches and warms your heart. So I just really, you know, the show started out because I figured that it would be fun to do and that it would help my business and stuff like that. But it's turned into so much more for me. It's turned into, you know, bringing families together. It's turned into, you don't know how many bakers come to me from all over the world and say, thank you, buddy. And I said, for what? They said, you know, now little kids want to peek through the window of my bakery and see the cakes that I'm making and ask me if I make cakes like the cake boss. And then you get the kids who are inspired and say, I want to be a baker like you, and get more people who want to get feel good about coming into the industry that we're in. So it's been my privilege and my honor to be that representative and be that person. Because after the cameras go away, or however you want to call it, at the end of the day, I'm just a baker from Hoboken, New Jersey. That's who I'll always be. So, thank you. So it's funny, because I would say it was a while ago, maybe about 12 or 15 years ago, I remember standing in Las Vegas doing my demo. There was a few less people there, you know, because it wasn't as popular. But I remember talking to my fellow bakers and telling them, guys, you got to get involved in this fondant stuff. You know, it's the future. It's what people want. You know, and I'm like, once you learn how to use it, it's actually easier than icing and decorating a cake with buttercream. I mean, right or wrong, you know? You get people who know how to ice cakes and fondant, but they can't ice a cake and buttercream. It's funny. So, you know, I've always been on the forefront of trying to show people cutting-edge, you know, technology, cutting-edge innovations. And, you know, I think that, especially being at a convention like this, it's become such a global community. You know, the fondant work that you see coming out of all over the world, I mean, from Australia to South Africa to Europe to Nigeria to South America, I mean, all over the world, we come together as a community, and it's all about cake decorating. And it's funny because you see so many cool innovations. Look, that's who we are. We're the type of people that we figure out how to get it done. You know, like, I'll take credit for the steamer, all right? I think I was probably the first person I ever saw to use a steamer. It was by accident. It was totally by accident. You know, I was doing a cake, and I would use a steamer to set the petal dust on my flour so it wouldn't fall off. And I had the steamer going, and I accidentally kicked it off, and then I was putting the flowers, and then the steamer was blowing on another cake. And then I was like, oh my God. But then I pulled it away, and I was like, hey, wait. I'm like, it looks pretty cool. And then I started playing with it a little more, and I realized, look, if you steam it, you could stick something right on it. It's quick. If you got cornstarch on a colored fondant, you could steam the cornstarch off. So at the end of the day, it's little things like that that have been innovating, or, you know, using tools or using things from clay molds and stuff like that. So there's been a lot of innovation. And at the end of the day, I inspire from you people. I look at your designs, I walk around, and I'm so proud and